Medical gas therapy is one of the most common types of respiratory care. It involves the process of delivering pressurized gases to treat a wide variety of pulmonary conditions. In this video, we will provide an overview of medical gas therapy and how it is used in the field of respiratory care. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. What is medical gas therapy? As previously mentioned, medical gas therapy is a treatment modality in which gas is administered to the patient. Each medical gas, including oxygen, is considered to be a drug. This means that it should only be administered with the approval of a qualified physician or a respiratory therapist. When delivering medical gas therapy, it's important to consider the types of gas, dosage, and delivery method. Each may vary depending on the patient's condition. First, let's talk about the types of medical gases. There are several different types of medical gases that are used in the healthcare setting, including oxygen, air, Heliox, nitric oxide, and Carbogen. Each type of gas has different uses, indications, and contraindications. As a respiratory therapist, you must be familiar with the delivery of each type. Oxygen is the most common medical gas that is delivered. It's used to treat patients with hypoxemia, dyspnea, and acute or chronic respiratory conditions. Medical air is considered to be a medical grade gas because it's been treated to remove impurities. It is primarily used for respiratory support in the hospital setting. Heliox is a mixture of helium and oxygen. This gas has a low density, which is useful for treating acute obstructive disorders. It's also used to treat croup, severe asthma, and post-extubation stridor. Nitric oxide is a colorless, odorless medical gas that promotes vascular smooth muscle relaxation. It helps improve blood flow to vented alveoli, which results in improved oxygenation and decreased shunting. Carbogen is a mixture of oxygen and carbon dioxide, and is a medical gas that is rarely used today. However, this gas has previously been used to treat hiccups, carbon monoxide poisoning, and congenital cardiac anomalies in neonates. Now let's talk about oxygen therapy. Oxygen therapy is the process of administering oxygen for therapeutic purposes. The primary goal of delivering oxygen therapy is to maintain tissue oxygenation throughout the body. This helps prevent hypoxemia while minimizing the cardiopulmonary workload so that the heart and lungs can function properly. Hypoxemia is a medical term that refers to low levels of oxygen in arterial blood. Some of the most common causes of hypoxemia include anemia, ARDS, asthma, COPD, emphysema, chronic bronchitis, interstitial lung disease, atelectasis, pneumonia, pneumothorax, pulmonary edema, congestive heart failure, pulmonary embolism, pulmonary fibrosis, and sleep apnea. These are just a few common examples, as there are many disease processes that can cause inadequate oxygenation. But again, the primary goal of oxygen therapy is to treat hypoxemia and decrease the workload that it imposes on the patient's heart and lungs. Now we need to discuss the oxygen delivery system. Oxygen delivery requires the use of a device that facilitates gas flow to the patient's airways. Some examples of the oxygen delivery system that are used include nasal cannula, nasal catheter, transtracheal catheter, reservoir cannula, simple mask, partial rebreathing mask, non-rebreathing mask, air entrainment mask, oxyhood, isolate, and oxygen tent. Each type has different uses, indications, advantages, and disadvantages. Respiratory therapists are required to understand how to deliver oxygen therapy with each delivery system, which we've covered each individually in other videos and resources in our channel and website. The different types of delivery systems include low flow, high flow, reservoir, and enclosure. Low flow delivery systems provide oxygen at flows of 8 liters per minute or less. This includes nasal cannulas, nasal catheters, and transtracheal catheters. High flow delivery systems provide oxygen at flows that equal to or exceed the patient's peak inspiratory flow. This includes air entrainment masks, air entrainment nebulizers, blending systems, and high-flow nasal cannulas. Reservoir delivery systems are effective because they can gather and store oxygen between the patient's breaths. Some examples include simple masks, reservoir cannulas, partial rebreathing masks, and non-rebreathing masks. Enclosure delivery systems provide oxygen by completely enclosing the patient from the outside environment. This includes oxygen hoods, isolates, and oxygen tents. Another specific type that we should mention is hyperbaric oxygen therapy, which is a treatment modality in which the patient is exposed to 100% oxygen at pressures greater than the atmosphere absolute. This elevated pressure increases the amount of dissolved oxygen that can enter the body. Hyperbaric oxygen therapy promotes hyperoxygenation, vasoconstriction, enhanced host immune function, and neovascularization. It is most commonly used in respiratory care to treat patients with carbon monoxide poisoning. If you want to support the channel, be sure to like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching, have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.